The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us recite the prayer of the day in unison. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come with your abundant grace and might. Free us from sin that would obstruct your mercy, that willingly we may bear your redeeming love to all the world, for you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Since today, in addition to being Christmas Eve, is still the fourth Sunday of Advent, we have an Old Testament prophecy to read today, in addition to our gospel reading. From Isaiah 9, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Thank you.
Oliver's really talking. Been gone for a couple of weeks because Gail's been doing practice with bells after services. His language skills have really picked up during those few weeks. Today's gospel is recorded in St. Luke, the first chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But Mary was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Holy Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We have one more candle to light, which is the center candle. Thank you, Sharon. Let's see, Sharon?
Yes.
I need 4 bags of M&Ms.
Okay.
They're in the basket on the table. And you can bring me down that little group of, I don't know what we call
them. The small basket?
Yeah, the small basket. We have consistently tried to provide you with something to remind you of the coming of Christ and his birth. Well, you know where those go, so you can go to Oliver and to
Patience.
Patience, I'll get it right, and to Logan and Jesse.
Okay.
It gets a little more difficult every year to find something that I can irritate the Ford dealership with. They really do not like my attachments to my keys. This one is a little more difficult because it has very small openings on it. I do, however, have a ring on my key ring that it will go on. So you may have to look to add a little tiny piece to your key rings. It says, Star of Wonder, Star of Night, guide us to thy perfect light. And there's a picture of the creche and the star overhead on this. And if you want to use it as a pocket coin, I can't guarantee you it will fit in a parking meter. but if you're downtown and you are really in a bad place and don't have a quarter to throw in the meter or a dime or a nickel, maybe this will help. So I'm going to go ahead and let you pass those out to folks too. Melody and I have tried to make these gifts available as reminders to you every year because it's important for us to remember. And I have on my keychain, now let me see if I can find that keychain. Better be here. Oh, this one, look at this. This is a naked keychain. It's not for the one I use every day because I have the van here and we don't drive it very much. But on my other keychain, it's just loaded up and down with remembrances of Easter and of Christmas Eve. So I hope that you'll find a way to keep it prominent for yourselves. A reminder of the greatness of our God. And even in the announcement of her coming pregnancy, Mary was able to proclaim the greatness of the Lord. The Magnificat, which we do not have in our reading today, but which is an important part of our readings for this time in Mary's life, really does proclaim the greatness of the Lord. And we also see that in our reading from Isaiah today, the way in which God took the circumstances of the Hebrews in hand and provided for them an opportunity to be the conquerors instead of the victims. Perhaps that's the most important thing for us to come to on Christmas, is the fact that in God's greatness, he has come and created for us a situation in which we are not the conquered or the victims, but we are the victorious and the conquerors over death itself. It's really critical and crucial for us to remember that. And that's why this celebration is so important. It seems like such a humble beginning. But stop and think of what happened. We have the star over our altar, which was a gift from Della Johnson in loving memory of her husband, Marley. And it hangs there throughout the year, and it will be lighted through the Christmas season and in addition throughout the season of Epiphany as we approach Lent. It's an opportunity for us to be reminded that in his greatness, God provided a light shining as a guide for the shepherds and the wise men to come to find this newborn king. That light shines in each of us, and it is the call of God on our lives, our great God, to be the light which comes into the world and shines for others. Sharon shared a story with me today I always have to try to be open because I never know when God's going to give me something at the last minute. And Sharon's story was about that. She met a young man who was asking for signatures for a petition, and Sharon said to him, "God bless you for doing this." And he said, "No one's ever said that to me." And Sharon said to him, "Well, women's rights are very important, and I'm, you know, this is an important petition to be distributed." And then she began talking about her 29 foster children. Discovered that this 30-year-old man was a former foster child who didn't get a permanent home, but was in the system until age 18 when he aged out of the system. What an opportunity for Sharon to become a shining light in the life of this young man who had not had the experience of having a permanent family or a permanent home. How often do these things come to us and we become the bearers of the natal light of Jesus Christ in the lives of other people? That's how great our God is. We didn't get left alone to do this on our own, by the way. Christ gifts us with his Spirit so that we might be that light for others. You know, it's certainly easier to not be. It's a lot easier to ignore the plight of the person checking out groceries in front of us who has to set aside a third of their groceries because they've run out of money. And they're, in all likelihood, using a SNAP card, which is just, they've extended its use through the month, and the money isn't left any longer on it to use. It's easy for us to stand there in that line and think, "Well, that's really just too bad, isn't it? Maybe if you'd been careful with your money, you would have enough money to buy your groceries." Ooh, but that's not what the light of Christ calls us to. The light of Christ, was that a head? I hope not. I've heard some big clunks on these pews over the years. No, the light of Christ calls us not to make a judgment, but instead to bear the light of Christ into the life of that person, to do what it is possible for us to do, because our great God has loved us so much and filled us with the light of Christ that we are able to let that light shine through us. Like the song that tells us how deep and dark it was, you know, at the time of Christ's birth, and it was indeed deep and dark, not just because Mary was about to deliver a baby with no room in the inn and they were stuck in a stable. It was deep and dark for the Jewish people at that time. They were overrun by the Romans. They were the authoritative king in their country was a stinker, and he didn't want to get replaced under any possibility by another king. And so he was ready to set about the process of destroying all children under a certain age to make sure he got the one. He was willing to kill hundreds and perhaps even thousands. That is the darkness into which Christ was born. That kind of darkness still exists in the world for us today. That darkness is all around us. But there are beacons of light in every corner of this planet because of the love of God, our great God, who has sent his son Jesus Christ. A miracle of God's love for every one of us. And what we discover is we don't have to agree necessarily politically. We don't have to agree economically. There are lots of things about which we can disagree in this world. We voice them very loudly. It's too bad we don't voice our agreement in Christ quite as loudly. But it is the light that is in, with, and around us through Jesus Christ that makes us to be possible for us to be together in the body of Christ. I bet you I could sit down with every single one of you and we could find some point of disagreement between us. But that's not what's important. What is important is that the Christ of God is with us. This child born in Bethlehem in these simple beginnings is the greatest gift of all time for all people. And it is because of God's grace and love for us. We watch the movie The Star. That's actually what this gospel text is about. Is really from the movie The Star. The movie The Star comes out of this gospel text. There were plenty of points of disappointment, plenty of struggles, plenty of problems, plenty of near misses for being harmed. But in it all, God put things together in such a way that Mary would make it to that stable, that Mary and Joseph would get there. In the midst of all of the darkness that surrounded them, they would get there, and in the midst of all of that taking place, this bountiful light shines down on Bethlehem. Oh, that it would shine on Bethlehem in the same way today. It's very sad. But the light of Christian people shines in spite of the darkness, shines through it. How does John start his entire gospel? The light has shined in the darkness, and the darkness has not, and I'd like to add, nor will it ever overcome it. You and I are that light. And on this Christmas, may we beam with the presence of Christ in us and find great and continuing joy in every day that is a gift from God for us. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we thank you for breaking into the darkness of the world with the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. He fills our lives with possibility and hope. He helps us to shine brightly as his light in the world, a process which unfolds for us as we grow in faith, another gift from you. As we come before you with the burden of our guilt and sin taken off our shoulders by the power of Jesus Christ, we are set free to be your children in the world who bring that very same hope that we have received to all people we meet. Help us to be the light of Christ in every situation and circumstance in which we find ourselves. And when we are in deep and dark places in our lives, send to us those whose light shines brightly, who will lift us up, hold us up, care for us, and bring us back so that we might see the path that you have set before us in this life. We pray today for those who are suffering with illnesses. We pray for Robert, who has had RSV and bronchitis and is still in the process of recovering. We thank you for helping him to get to the kind of care he has needed in order to ultimately be healed. We give you thanks that Regina Stewart, who's been through a difficult time of bronchitis, is whole and healthy again. We pray for Melody's brother and his wife, and my brother and his wife, who are beginning to age and have many, many health problems. We pray for your presence with them to continue to help them find the joy in life in Jesus Christ. We thank you that Terry Hardy is able to be out and driving now, and we pray for the continued health of her ankle and foot. We pray for Candace. The reports for Candace are not really very good, and we pray that you'll help guide the doctors who are working with her to find the kind of treatment that will work to reduce the tumors in her body. And we pray for your presence with Lisa, Candace's wife, as she takes care of Candace and maintains a household and tries to keep everything together. And she does it with such faith and trust in you. We pray for our brother in Christ, Paul, who's in jail, that this time of the Christmas season might not pass him by without his realizing how much you have been present with him in this very difficult time in his life. And we give you thanks for Bethlehem's birth, for the infant child of Mary and the Spirit, and for the grace of Joseph, who accepted all of this and moved forward to raise Jesus as a faithful child. Be with us in our joy and celebrations with our family and friends. If we are alone, help us to remember that you are with us and that your desire is for us to be filled with joy, even if we have a tendency to be alone on this holiday. And keep us in your care as your children every single day, keeping us safe in our travels, journeying by our side in all the times and places and circumstances of our lives. And most of all, we give you thanks for the prayer hymns of the church, which we can sing with such joy and celebration, that lift our hearts and call us to greater and greater faith and trust in you. And Lord, by your promise, we offer this prayer with assurances of its being heard in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. In addition, Lord, we pray for Annette's friend, Dorothy, and for her Aunt Kathy. And we pray for Annette, too, for healing, Lord, that you'll be with her as she continues to deal with the pain in her back and knees. We pray for doctors to find the things that will work for her to give her relief. Hear us, O God. Mercy is made. In Christ, oops, another one. Gracious Lord, we pray for Kat Doss, who is caring for Pam, Holly's oldest sister, and now going through that time of life that comes to women called menopause. And she is busy with constant care for her sister. Be with Kat and keep her in your care, as well as with Pam, and bless them with your living and loving presence and the calm and peace of knowing Jesus Christ. Hear us, O God. We offer these prayers too in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please greet one another this morning with the peace of the Lord. Let us prepare our hearts now to receive this holy sacrament of Jesus Christ, living presence. Present in the bread and wine of Holy Communion by the power of the Holy Spirit. On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray the prayer our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please come and receive the sacrament of our Lord. Best one you're going to hear, folks. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace now and forever. Amen. Thank you.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.
My mama used to tell me stories.